Visual Basic 2008 Express Edition, because that's the version of Visual Basic I'll be using in the majority of my tutorials. So how to do it? Well, the first thing you need to do is go online, and with a search engine, so Google in this instance, just do a quick search for Visual Basic 2008 Express. And get options there and do a search. The first hit there I will need, and you'll go to this page after a delay, and you just go down to download now, choose your language and click on download. And sometimes it can be a little bit of a wait here, because Microsoft obviously got a lot of demand on this website to get hold of Visual Basic, so I'm going to pause for a second while I wait for Microsoft to respond. And after a while, you get this box up on screen. As I said, it takes quite a while. This took me about a minute to get this this dialogue box up. And what we want to do is either save it or run it at a later date. I'm just going to run it now, so click on Run. And then it'll start the setup process. Again, I'm going to pause while it does this. And then you'll get the security warning. Do you want to run this software? So I'm going to run it. Sometimes you don't get a second dialogue up, you just get one up, in this case out of two. And then, after a slight wait, it'll extract the files. Then, it'll ask you what you want to install. Now, obviously, it's going to install Visual Basic anyway, but it's going to give you some other options in a minute, so I'll just pause while I wait for that. You'll get the installation components information box saying it's going to take a while to happen. Just let it run, don't worry about that. Pause again, and once setup has finished extracting the files, you'll get this dialog box up. They ask you, do you want to send information? I don't bother with that. Go to next. You obviously have to accept the license terms. I turn the RSS content off because I don't want internet traffic cluttering my computer. Go to next. Now, it asks you if you want to install Silverlight and SQL Server as well. Now, if you're going to use SQL, you may as well install it, but don't forget, you need to install the management tools as well. So I'm just going to turn these off for now, because I don't want Silverlight, and I don't want SQL Server. I'm just installing Visual Basic this time. Go to next. And it'll tell you where it's going to install all the files. It'll tell you how much disk you need and how big the download is. And then it tells you you've got to connect to the internet to proceed with the installation. So go to install. And now it'll start downloading. So obviously I'm going to pause while it does this, because I've only got an 8 meg connection. It's going to take a while. And I'll resume when it's finished. And you can see everything. It'll install all of the 9 components. So I'll just pause again while it does that. Then once the installation is complete, you'll see this screen. You've got to register within 30 days. Don't worry, it's free. Just you've got to do it to get it activated, basically. And click on exit. And then once that's done, you've got your Visual Basic installed. I can see I've somehow managed to do click on it twice. And that's it, really. That's how you install your Visual Basic. Now, to run it, you just go down to your Start menu. Go to All Programs. And you'll have it installed there, Visual Basic 2008 Express Edition. Open it up. You get the first time configuration message. It might take a few minutes, so I'll just pause while I wait. And then once you've opened it the first time, you'll have the Express Edition window up here, and you're ready to go. And you can start your programming. And that's it. That's how you install Visual Basic. The shortened version, obviously, because you've got a lot of waiting around for the download and the install. And we're done.